one of the most mysterious cities of Anatolia, full of natural beauty in every corner, is Isparta. The people of the city value beauty and say of it, buy roses, sell roses, weigh a rose with a rose. The entire bazaar is full of roses. Known as the City of Roses, Isparta is one of the most popular provinces of our country, found in the Western Mediterranean region. Isparta was founded before Christ was born in an area known as Pisidia. The area had once been ruled by the Hittites, subsequently by the Phrygians, Lydians, and Persians. Historically, its name of Pisidia has been encountered as early as the 5th century BC. Bardis, as it had been named by the ancient Lydians, has become modern Isparta. The city was conquered by the Turks during the time of Kılıç Arslan III in 1204. Was a borough known as Hamidabad, which was within the jurisdiction of the city of Konya prior to the Republic and became a province in 1923, being given the name Isparta in 1926. Isparta is well deserving of attention with its ancient cities and was built in antiquity during the Hellenistic era. One of the most important ancient cities built during ancient times was Pisidia Antiochia, located in the borough of Yalvaç, and which was once the capital. Augustus Temple, a natural temple located at the highest point of the city. The theater, located in the centrum. The Roman bath antique aqueducts are among the most significant ruins of the city. The men's holy area, located in the northeast of the city, proves that a culture lived in the region prior to the Hellenistic era. St. Paul's Church, where one of the first sermons was given, and which is one of the first Christian churches, is located in Antiochia. These holy areas have turned the borough of Yalvaç into a faith tourism center. Today, hiking programs are organized in Yazılı Canyon, through which St. Paul is believed to have passed when he came to Antiochia. The St. Paul Trail begins in Antalya and continues up to Yalvaç and is one of the longest hiking routes in Turkey with a total distance of 500 kilometers. Another city that dates back to the Hellenistic era is the ancient city of Adada. According to research, it was discovered that the ancient city of Adada was also an important bishopric center with these ruins along with the Agora, various temples, theater, administrative building, the road stretching up to Perge, and the necropolis reflects the level of civilization that the ancient city of Adada had reached. One of the significant parts of Isparta's accumulation of thousands of years of history and culture is the Yermedon outdoor temple located at the entrance of Aksu Zindan Cave. During the excavations conducted around the temple, a church and side walls dating back to the Roman age were found. The cave, located behind the Yermedon outdoor temple, is deserving of attention with its 765-meter-long stalactites and stalagmites. Due to its geographical position, Isparta has always remained an important passageway. To that end, several castles dating back to the different eras have been found that survive even today. Eğirdir Castle, Sırlık Castle, and Uluborlu Castle are among the many castles to be found in the area. Isparta played an important role in Anatolia's process of becoming Turkish land. Following the Battle of Malzigert and then the Battle of Mirkefelon, which was won in 1176, took place on Isparta's soil. Isparta, which was ruled by the Hamid Oğulları Sultanate for a while, became part of Ottoman soil after the collapse of the Anatolian Selçuk Empire in 1426. Isparta was an important center in the field of science as well as that of the military during the time of the Anatolian Selçuks. Ertuğrul Mendresesi, the Muslim theological school located in Atabey, was founded by Mübareddin Ertuğrul in 1224. Dündar Bey Medresesi, located in the borough of Eirdir, is another structure built during the time of the Selçuks. Medrese was built in 1301 as a two-story building, has a courtyard in the center. Dündar Bey Medresesi has a huge entry gate and that is still used by the Grand Bazaar today. Uluborlu Alaaddin Mosque was built in 1231 during the Sultanate of Alaaddin Keykubat. Şarkık Karaağaç Ulu Mosque was built in 1281. Hızır Bey Mosque was built in 1325. Firdevs Bey Mosque was built in 1561. The Devlet Han Mosque was built in the 16th century. These are among the most significant structures still in use today. Eirdir Karavansaray and Gelen Dost Ertokuş Karavansaray, located on the Silk Road, are among the most important inns. Aya Payana, built in 1750, and Aya İşotya, built in 1858, are places of worship dating back to the Ottoman era when different religions were tolerated and are among the most important churches in the city. One of the most amazing examples of the area's rich historical and cultural accumulation can be seen in Isparta, Yalvaç, and Uluborlu museums. The works of art seen in the museums are never forgotten by those who visit them. Isparta has a rich cultural collection of historical assets that also include not only the architecture, but the rich variety of folkloric songs, dances, mania, wedding ceremonies, meals, and traditional clothes. Traditional Spartan houses still resonate to the sound of the kirkit, a traditional weaving instrument whose sounds continue to be heard, reverberating from the past to this day among the dwellers of this illustrious city in which the richness of the past comes into our hearts to this day. The geography of the area and the character of the people living in the area are reflected in the folkloric dances. The most popular of these folkloric dances include the Zeybek and the Teke. The richness of Isparta is expressed in not only its folkloric dances, its being the center of the lakes region, its being a major tourism center with all kinds of natural beauty and culture, but also with the delights of the city. Lake Eirdir, located within the borders of Isparta, is a natural asset on its own. The mountains with differing heights that surround the lake contribute to the beauty of Lake Eirdir, which is the pearl of the area. The city also houses many other natural beauties, such as Lake Kovada, the crater Lake Gölcük, Lake Beyşehir, and Lake Burdur within its borders. This natural structure is suitable for lake and mountain tourism and has become a unique piece of land with other facilities such as fishing, water sports, and many kinds of nature sports. Mount Davraz is located between Lakes Eirdir and Kovada and surmounts the Isparta Plain with a height of 2,637 meters. There is a truly magnificent view from the mountain of the Anatolian Plain and Lake Eirdir. The Davraz Skiing Center is located 26 kilometers from the city center and 150 kilometers from Antalya, and is one of the most significant tourism centers of the Mediterranean region. It's possible to reach the summit by chairlift in order to be awed by the amazing view of Lake Eirdir while visiting the Mountain House Cafe or skiing. Davraz is suitable for north discipline, alp discipline, tour skiing, snowboarding, telemark, mountaineering, botanic observation, paragliding, and trekking activities. The Davraz Skiing Center is an indispensable camping site for the professional sports enthusiasts. Excursion spots that further enrich the natural beauty of Isparta for visitors and locals of Isparta include the exquisite cuisine. The most famous dish in Isparta is the fırınkebabı, also carp covered with cracked wheat from delicious fish caught in Lake Eirdir, and the neighborhood bakeries of the borough of Yalvaç are among the most important staples of Esparta cuisine. Synonymous with the name of Esparta are the growing of roses and the production of Turkish carpets. Carpeting began in Esparta with the settlement of Turkish tribes following the conquest of Anatolia. In recent years, production of miniature carpets has become an important addition to this industry. The rose served as a staple income in Esparta for several years, and though still its highly regarded symbol, is not as prevalent as it used to be. The unique climatic conditions in Esparta make it one of the few cities in the world that grow roses for exportation of high-grade rose oil. More than half of the world's rose oil production comes from Esparta. The products made of Spartan roses are among the number one souvenir choices for domestic and foreign tourists. Esparta's economy is dependent on agriculture. Apples, cherries, and the growth of flowers is a substantial part of the local economy. 20% of Turkey's apple production comes from Esparta, and these apples are preferred because of their scent and taste. Esparta is one of the fastest growing cities in our country. Today, Esparta is still a city of education, health, and culture. With its ever-increasing number of students and hospitals, Süleyman Demirel University, which was founded in 1992, is among the leading universities of Turkey. Apart from its modern education and healthcare institutions, the natural and cultural assets of the university enrich the living quality of residents of the city. Whether you approach the city by air, land, road, or railroad, you will appreciate the bountifulness of this place. Regardless of what you are seeking, whether sports or a holiday, nature's bounty, history or recreation, you will be fully satisfied by the rich diversity you will find here. Winter tourism, hiking, jeep treks or photo safaris, healthcare, religion, plateau camping, caravans, cave tourism options, cliff hanging, plants, birds and beetle observation, and paragliding are extremely rich options that increase the quality of your life. This city is the right one for you, your family, and friends to discover, have fun, and relax. Esparta's rich tapestry of roads start in the mists of antiquity and are embroidered with a present that has everything from rose fields to carpet looms. The pace of life continues at the pace that you would seek to find. The future is here, but the past is with us.